So, 1 rupee received today is not equal to 1 rupee received on future day. Today's money has got more value than future money. This is due to inflation and then risk. Today money has more purchasing power and today money is more certain. This difference in value of money due to time, we call it as time value of money. The time value of money is expressed as a percentage. The percentage has got two components, the inflation rate and the risk premium. So two companies, when you make deposits, will the time value be same? No. Suppose I deposit in RBI, I may be happy with the 6% interest rate. I deposit with an RBF, I may be asking 20% interest rate. Reason is, more risk we take, we require more return to compensate for the risk taking. That is, the risk premium changes as the risk profile of the companies changes. So this is what we refer to as time value of money. Here we saw that cash flows at different points of time received cannot be added or subtracted as it is, because they have different values due to time. 1 rupee in first year plus 1 rupee in second year plus 1 rupee in third year is not equal to 3 rupees. How I cannot add a dollar and a pound? I cannot add a first year rupee and second year rupee because they have different values due to time. So we have two options. First, bring all the cash flows into a common time frame, which can be bring everything into today's terms. If you do that, we are said to be calculating present value. Or bring everything into the future terms, we are said to be calculating future value. Present value calculated using the technique called as discounting. Future value using a technique called as compounding. Can I push it or not? Next. So the present value of cash flows is also called as discounted cash flows. And future value cash flow is also called as compounded cash flows. We complete our discussion by saying that there are four types of cash flows. What are the four types of cash flow? Single cash flow, annuity cash flow, perpetual cash flow, multiple uneven cash flow. Single cash flow is the cash flow received only once. For example, end of third year, 1 lakh. I have received the cash flow once. Annuity tell me how to write it. 1 to 3 years, 1 lakh. Means end of first year, end of second year, end of third year, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh. Perpetual is also annuity only, but annuity that never ends. We call as perpetuity. Forever annuity is perpetuity. 1 to infinite years, 1 lakh. Multiple and even, different years, different cash flows are received. First year, suppose 1 lakh, second year it is 4 lakhs, and third year it is 3 lakhs. These are all the different types of cash flows. What is that we are going to learn in this chapter? How to discount a single cash flow, how to discount an annuity cash flow, how to discount a perpetual cash flow, how to discount a multiple uneven cash flow. To put it simply, how to calculate present values of all those four cash flows is the main first stage of discussion, right or not? Similarly, we also learn how to compound a single annuity, perpetual and multiple uneven cash flow. That is called as future value calculation. With this, we complete at the last class discussion, right or not? This class we are going to start doing the problems. Before that, everybody has the calculator or not?
Yes, sir.
Do you have the calculator as per the requirement set by me? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I think you're all having it. Okay, now please stop talking. Stop talking. Now Shall we start? Please. Okay. ஃபாஸ்ட் ஏன் முள்ளது வராது? ஸ்பீடு ஸ்பீட் ஸ்பீட் நான் வாக்கிங் ஸ்டிக் ஒன்லி ஹாவ் டு கிவ் யூ பேலன்ஸ் ஓகே ஸ்டாப் ஓகே சரி Now let us start with the example 1. In the chapter, predominantly we'll discuss present value. We'll discuss what? Present value. At the end of that chapter, in a 40 minutes time, I'll discuss the future value. We don't give so much importance to future value as what we give to present value in our classroom discussion, because most of the chapters requires present value calculations only. Everybody connected or not? No. I start with the example number 1. How to calculate present value of a single cash loan? Okay. The question is, year 3 I receive 1 lakh. Interest rate is 10%. What is the present value? Everybody can start or not? Now, to put it simply, at the end of the third year, suppose I want 1 lakh. At the end of the day, I want 1 lakh. What is the value today is the issue. Everybody following the question or not? No. The interest rate is what? 10%. I'll put it in the form understandable to you much more. Okay. Suppose at the end of the third year, I want to buy some jewelries. Okay. For that, how much money is required? 1 lakh. One example I say. Or I want 1 lakh at the end of third year for some education purpose. That is good, okay? I want 1 lakh for some education purpose at the end of the third year. I want to put some money today itself so that I'll get 1 lakh at the end of the third year. Tell me, today should I deposit 1 lakh, more than 1 lakh, less than 1 lakh? So why less than 1 lakh? Along with interest, it will grow to what? 1 lakh. So question is, how much will you deposit today? Is a question. That is called as present value calculation. Everybody understanding or not? What is the value of 1 lakh today if the interest rate is 10%? Is a question. Everybody understanding the question or not? Now, let me discuss in the sheet and then put in the slide where I'll give a much more formal way of calculation. So now let us have a discussion now. Can we start up? Now. We all have studied in our school days or as recently as in our CPT compound interest formula. Remember? Yes, remember or not? No. Tell me, what is the formula? Amount is equal to principal into 1 plus r power n. You may write I or r. I write what? R. R means rate of interest. I deposit the principal today and it is going to give a rate of interest R for how many years? N years. It will maturity, a maturity value of amount. Everybody yes or no? This is a maturity value, this is a deposit, this is a interest rate, this is a number of years. Is the time value of any formula or the compound interest formula? Everybody, are you all following or not? No. This is what I am going to now write. Amount is today's money or tomorrow's money? Tomorrow's money. I call the amount as future value is equal to principal is today's money or tomorrow's money? Today's money. I call this as what? Present value into what? 1 plus r power n is our formula. Everybody yes or no? So future value is nothing but what? Present value into 1 plus r power n is equal to future value. Are you all comfortable or not? No. If I want to calculate present value, tell me what is present value? Present value is equal to future value divided by 1 plus r power n, or future value into 1 by 1 plus r power n. This you are all able to accept it or not? So present value is equal to future value into 1 by 1 plus r power n is the answer. Everybody accept it or not? Now, tell me, I have to calculate for this problem present value. Present value is equal to after 3 years, how much I want as maturity value, what the future value? 1 lakh. The future value is 1 lakh into 1 by 1 plus R. Tell me, what is the rate of interest, everybody? 10%. How you will write 10%? 0.10. 1 plus 0.10 is what? 1.10 into 1.10 power 3. Everybody understanding or not? So 1 lakh into 1.10 power 3. Can somebody just tell me what is the number? 1 lakh into what is 1 by 1.10 power 3? Take the calculator. 0.7513. I'll be getting how much here? 75,130. Okay, 75,130. Everybody, yes or no? In other words, depositing today 75,130 will grow to how much at the end of the third year? 1 lakh. And the interest rate is 10%. Or 75,130 today is as good as what? 1 lakh received after 3 years is the meaning of this. Everybody, are you understanding it or not? Please tell me yes or no. Now, see, let us understand what is happening here, which may be very helpful in some IRR, NPV conflicts and all in the later stages. I want to understand the concept of reinvestment assumption here. Can I put it or not? Now, if 75,130 has to become 1 lakh after 3 years, I should make investment how many times? I should make investment 4 times. I should invest a principal of 1 lakh. Every year when I earn interest, I should not eat my interest. I have to what? Reinvest the interest. Then only it will be growing into what? The 1 lakh at the end of the third year. Everybody, yes or no? This is what we call as a reinvestment assumption. Our entire finance subject is built around, not only in inter, final, everywhere. Our entire subject of finance is built around this assumption called as reinvestment assumption, where we don't consume money, we reinvest money, allow it to grow further and further. Everybody following or not? Now, let us understand what is happening. Okay, tell me, what is the present value of 1 lakh after 3 years today? 75,130. Provided the interest rate is 10%. Let us see what is happening. Okay, see. Here, and cash flow. Okay, today year 0, suppose I deposit how much rupees? 1 lakh. Accepted? Now I am going to get interest. I am going to get what? Interest. First year interest. What is the interest percentage? 10%. Sorry. Year 75,130. First year, what is the interest? 10%. What is 10%? 7513. At the end of the first year, the money in my hand is 75,130 plus what? 7513. What's the amount? 82,643. This is the money at the end of the first year. Yes or no? Now I am going to get what? Second year interest. It will be calculated on 75,130 or 82,643. Because the interest is reinvested, it also becomes a principal. Yes or no? How much interest? 8264. Now, tell me, what is the money at the end of the second year? 90,907. Now, I am going to receive what? The third year interest. How much I receive? 9091. I receive how much interest? 9091. Now, at the end of the third year, what's the money? 99,998. I beg for 2 rupees. I make it as what? 1 lakh rupees. Rounding off problem. Everybody is on who? Now, this is how the 75,130 becomes what? 1 lakh at the end of the third year. Everybody, did you understand my calculations or not? Now, so this is how we should know that. Suppose I ask you a question. You want 1 lakh after 3 years or just 75,130, which is good? 1 lakh after 3 years or just 75,130 today, which is good? Both are equally good. Today 75,130 is as good as what? Getting 1 lakh after 3 years. Because if you get 75,130 today, you can deposit for 10% for 3 years and get the same 1 lakh. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? In other words, 1 lakh after 3 years is as good as what? 75,130 today, provided the interest rate is 10%. Suppose interest rate is 0%, no interest given. Then what happens here? 1 lakh after 3 years is what? 1 lakh today also. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, this is the next point I just wanted to discuss. Everybody following her? Now, we are going to make this discussion much more formal now. We're going to make the discussion much more formal now. See, how we calculated 75,130, 1 lakh into 0.7513, 1 lakh into 0.7513, okay. The 75,130 is called as present value of cash flow, or even also called as discounted cash flow. Because what cash flow? Discounted cash flow, because we have discounted it, okay. Now, I will write it this way. This is page 1, we discussed in 2, the next is what? 3. Now, see, I will present it this way. Discounted cash flow is equal to 1 lakh into 0.7513. Accept it? That's why I got what? 75,130. This 1 lakh is called as cash flow. This 1 lakh is called as what? Cash flow. It has not yet been discounted. Yes or no? It is called as what? Cash flow. This 0.7513, I give a name called as present value factor. What a 0.7513? Present value factor. And the 75,130 called as what? Discounted cash flow. Everybody is or no? Now, to put it simply, now I can say discounted cash flow is equal to cash flow into present value factor is a lesson number one we are learning. Everybody following not? What is discounted cash flow? Cash flow into present value factor. Everybody understanding or not? Now, in examination, suppose this is a problem. Just a simple understanding. This is a problem. 1 lakh after 3 years. What is the value today? They ask how to present the answer. Okay. The answer is presented as follows. We have the following 4 columns. First column is year. Second column is cash flow. Third column is present value factor at 10%. And the fourth column is discounted cash flow. This is how we present the answer in the examination. Year, cash flow, PV factor and discounted cash flow. First to 2 columns question will give. Year what? 3. I receive how much cash flow? 1 lakh. I want to know what is a 3 years present value factor at 10%. We calculate how much here? 0.7513. What a discounted cash flow? 75,130. Is how we should be understanding the presentation. Everybody, are you following or not? Now, I am formalizing it. Can I proceed to the next stage? I'll give you the notes fully. So now the question, tell me what is the question? Third year received 1 lakh. What is the value today? How to write the answer? Year, cash flow, present value factor, discounted cash flow. Year what? 3. How much I received cash? 1 lakh. So I have to find out the PV factor for 10%, 3 years. What is the number we calculated? 0.7513. The discounted cash flow is what? 75,130. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, the question is, sir, here I have to calculate present value factor or not? Tell me how to calculate this 0.7513. How to calculate the present value factor? Question arises. We are making it formal. Can I go say how to calculate PV factor? I can calculate present value factor in 3 ways. In how many ways here? 3 ways. Okay. So PV factor calculation now we are discussing. Okay. How to get the present value factor? There are how many ways? 3 ways. The first is formula. The first is what? Formula. Second is by using table. Third is by using calculator. Formula, table and then what? Calculator. Now, formula we know. What is the formula for calculating 0.7513? 1 by 1 plus r power n. What is the formula? 1 by 1 plus r power n. Tell me how to calculate 1 by 1.10 power 3. What is that? This answer here? 0.7513. That's how you calculate in the first place. Respond is so no. Now, The other way to do is what? Table. We have to see present value table. Let us see what table? Present value table against R person. How many years? N years. In this case, I have to see the table against how much person? 10 person. How many years? 3 years. Can somebody give me the workbook? Okay, you take the workbook. In the workbook, last I have given you table. I have given you what? Table. In that, I have given you two tables, please. One is table A3. If you see, one is table A3. Another is table A4. Namba pathi arikkaba? One is table A3. Another is table A4. A3 table is present value. A4 table is annuity, I call it. Okay, now, take table A3. What percentage, how many years? 10% is 3 years. Please look at against 3 years. How much percentage? 10%. What's the number? 0.751. The table has given in 3 decimals. We followed how many decimals? 4 decimals. So what is the percent value factor? 0.751. We wrote as what? 0.7513. Not an issue. It is 0.751. Is how we can find the same factor from table. You need not calculate PE factor. One can find it out from table. Everybody, yes or no? No. The third method is using what? Calculator. Somebody give me a calculator. Okay. So take the calculator. Okay. Now, please. We have to find the percent value factor for how much percent? 10%, 3 years. Very simple. Take the calculator. Type 1 divided by 1.10. Type 1 divided by 1.10. How many years? 3 years. So press is equal to 3 times. 1, 2, 3. I get what? 0.7513. Everybody yes or no? Suppose I want percent value factor for 5 years. It will be what? Is equal to 5 times. Shall I proceed? Now. So again I say, we have to find a percent value factor for 10%, 3 years. 1 divided by 1.10. First year gives you first year factor, second year factor is what? Third year factor, 0.7513. Yes, we have to find it out. Everybody, yes or no? Now, manage panikiriyaa pa calculator? Okay, now you just share the calculator. Now, so now, please, don't talk. First, you have to type, what you have to type? 1 by 1.10. Second step is what? Press is equal to how many times here? 3 times. Is a calculator. Everybody following or not? With this, we complete the small discussion on present value of a single cash flow. Please. In nutshell, how to write the answer? Year, cash flow, present value factor, discounted cash flow. Year and cash flow will be given in the question. Now we have to calculate only one number. What is that? Present value factor. How to calculate present value factor? 3 ways. One is what? Formula. Second is table. Third is calculator. Formula for PE factor is 1 by 1 plus R power N. Table is C, the present value table for 10%, 3 years. We'll be getting the factor straight away. And what is the calculator usage? 1 by 1.10 is equal to how many times? 3 times. We'll be getting the number as it is. So this is how, this is answer is how much? Answer is 0.7513 is the present value factor. Everybody is or no? Now, last point I'll discuss and complete and give it time to copy it. Okay, now. Sir, what is this 0.7513 present value factor? Very simple. PV factor means 1 rupee received after 3 years is equal to what today? 75 paise. Respond yes or no? Receiving 1 rupee after 3 years is as good as what? Receiving 75 paise today. So if the value, if the present value of 1 rupee after 3 years is 0.1513, what the present value of 1 lakh after 3 years, 1 lakh into 0.1513 gives you what? 75,130. So this is present value of 1 rupee, and the table name they would have given as what? Present value of rupee 1. Again, so many years, and then what? R percent is the issue. Everybody, are you understanding or not? Now, with this, we complete our example 1 regarding present value of a single cash flow. Please respond. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Can I proceed further?
Now,
let's copy all this. Then we'll be having 1 or 2 exercise problem done, and then we can just go for the next issue. Okay, now write down example 1, present value of single cash flow. Example 1, present value of single cash flow. Stop talking, please. Example 1, present value of single cash flow. Present value of single cash flow. Copy the example first. Finish copying up. Write down solution. Let's write the solution as we write in the exam. Okay, solution. Year cash flow. What's the third column? Present value factor at 10%. PVF at 10%. We can write the abbreviation. PVF means what? Present value factor. Even cash flow can be written as CF. All these are known abbreviations. Present value factor at 10%. Last column is discounted cash flow. We can even write as DCF. How everybody knows PVR means PV ratio. People know or not? BEP, break even point. Everybody knows or not? Like that, DCF is well known abbreviation. What is DCF? Discounted cash flow. We can write the abbreviation itself in the examination. Even you need not write it fully. Discounted cash flow. Are you following or not? Now, tell me the answer. Here, what you will write? 3. What is the cash flow after 3 years? 1 lakh. What the present value factor will write? 0.7513. Right? The present value factor is 0.7513. What a discounted cash flow? 75,130. Discounted cash flow 75,130. Discounted cash flow 75,130. 75,130. Can I proceed? Notes. Point number 1. Either answer, answer over. Answer has been completed. What a discounted cash flow? 75,130. That's a question now. Write down notes. Point number 1. Notes point number 1. How PVF is calculated? How present value factor is calculated? How present value factor is calculated? How present value factor is calculated? Branch it into 3. How present value factor is calculated? Branch it into 3. First branch, formula. First branch, formula. Second branch, table. Third branch, calculator. Formula, table and calculator. Formula, put a donimac and write. What is the formula for present value factor? 1/1 r/n. Formula, 1/1 r/n. 1/1 r/n. Is the formula for PVF. Again, put a down my control. In our problem, what is that we have to write? 1/1.10^3. 1/1.10^3. How much you got? 0.7513. 0.7513. Table, right? C, present value table. Table, right? C, present value table. Bracket la A3 table. In our workbook, the table name is what? A3 table, bracket close. For R percent N years. See present value table. For R percent N years. See present value table. For R percent N years. Down near mark and write 10% 3 years. 10% 3 years. Table gave you in 3 decimals, right, as it is. What's the table value? 0.751. Table value is 0.751. Table value 0.751. Calculator. Type 1 by 1.10. Note it down here. Type 1 by 1.10. Press is equal to 3 times. Press is equal to 3 times. What you get is how much? 0.7513. What you get is 0.7513. Press is equal to 3 times. You will be getting 0.7513. Everybody, yes or no? Now, next. Point number 1 or 2? Point number 2. What is present value factor? Point number 2. What is PVF? What is present value factor? Answer, right? The PVF of 0.7513 means the present value factor of 0.7513 means the PVF of 0.7513 means, come on, rupee 1 received after 3 years, the PVF of 0.7513 means rupee 1 received after 3 years is worth, rupee 1 received after 3 years is worth how much today? 75 paise today. 0.7513 round off to 75 paise. Okay, rupee 1 received after 3 years is worth 75 paise today if the interest is worth 75 paise today if the interest is, fill in the blanks, if the interest is 10%. If the interest is 10%. If the interest is 10%. Do you understand the meaning of present value factor or not? Next, point number 3. Understanding discounting. Point number 3. Understanding discounting. All this are for your revision and getting a clarity of the subject. Answer already over. The table answer, that's all. Okay. Now, understanding discounting. Point number 3. Understanding discounting. Now, write the formula. I start from here because I believe you all know compound interest formula. Okay. Amount is equal to, right? Amount is equal to principal into 1 plus r power n. Amount is equal to principal into 1 plus r power n. Amount is equal to principal into 1 plus r power n. Amount is today money, maturity money, maturity. It is today or future? Future. Future value is equal to, future value is equal to present value into 1 plus r power n. Future value is equal to present value into 1 plus r power n. Present value is equal to future value divided by 1 plus r power n. Present value is equal to future value divided by 1 plus r power n. Present value is equal to future value divided by 1 plus r power n. Or future value into 1 by 1 plus r power n. Both are same. Future value into 1 by 1 plus r power n. Present value is equal to 1 lakh into 1 by 1.10 power 3. Present value is equal to 1 lakh into 1 by 1.10 power 3 is equal to 1 lakh into 0.7513 is equal to 1 lakh into 0.7513. Here you can write, circle that 1 lakh. You call that 1 lakh as what? Cash flow. We call this 1 lakh as cash flow. Circle the 0.7513. It is called as what? PV factor. It is called as PV factor. Is equal to 75,130. Is equal to 75,130. Is equal to 75,130. Right. That is DCF is equal to 75,130. Then discounted cash flow. DCF is equal to, tell me what? Cash flow into present value factor. DCF is equal to cash flow into present value factor. This is how you understand the discounting. DCF is equal to cash flow into present value factor. Cash flow into present value factor. Everybody understanding or not? Next, point number 3 or 4? Point number 4. Rupees 75,130 today. Rupees 75,130 today grows to. Rupees 75,130 today grows to how much rupees? 1 lakh after 3 years. Rupees 75,130 today grows to 1 lakh after 3 years at 10%. As follows. Rupees 75,130 today grows to rupees 1 lakh after 3 years at 10%. Grows to rupees 1 lakh after 3 years at 10% as follows. As follows. Okay. Copy this. Year cash flow. Copy this. Year cash flow. Year 0, 75,130. Year cash flow. Year 0, 75,130. Interest first year. What is first year interest? 7513. Interest first year 7513. What is the cash flow at the end of the first year? 82643. How I have 82643 at the end of the first year? I deposited 75130 and the bank gave me 7513. So the money at the end of the first year is 82643. Next, interest 2, second year interest, interest 2, what is 10% of 82643, 8264, interest 2 is 8264, tell me what is the cash flow at the end of the second year, 90,907, at the end of second year the cash flow is 90,907, interest 3, how much is interest 3? 9091. Interest 3 is 9091. Tell me what is the third year cash flow end year? 99,998. 99,998 or round off to what? 1 lakh. 99,998 or 1 lakh. 99,998 or 1 lakh. This is how one should understand the present value calculation. Everybody, yes or no? Now, all of you, stop writing. Everything you just forget. Tell me the answer. Single cash flow, how to calculate present value? Tell me the columns. Year cash flow, present value factor, and discounted cash flow. How to calculate present value factor? 3 ways. First is using formula. What the formula? 1 by 1 plus r power n. Or see what table? Present value table. Straight away number will be obtained. Or use what? Calculator. Type 1 divided by 1 point something is equal to n times. Gives you the present value factor. That's all. Everybody understood or not? Can I proceed? Now, let us do 2 exercise sums for us to get a grip. And then go for the annuity next. Write down. Exercise 1. Exercise 1. Exercise 1. Can I proceed? Head on. Mr. Ram requires 50 lakhs. Mr. Ram requires rupees 50 lakhs for his daughter's marriage. It will become normal, okay? Mr. Ram requires 50 lakhs for his daughter's marriage after 10 years. Mr. Ram requires rupees 50 lakhs for his daughter's marriage after 10 years. How much should he deposit today? How much should he deposit today? How much should he deposit today? if the interest rate is 8%, how much should he deposit today if the interest rate is 8%? If the interest rate is 8%. If the interest rate is 8%. Can we do the solution or not? No. So how much Ram requires after 10 years? After 10 years, how much he requires here? 50 lakh. So should he deposit today 50 lakhs or less than 50 lakhs or less than 50 lakhs? How much you deposit today? Percent value of 50 lakhs. You have to calculate, right or not? Now, write the solution. Write solution. Okay. Tell me all of you, let's do it systematically. What are all the columns? Here, second column is cash flow. Third column is percent value factor at what percent? 8%. Last column is discounted cash flow. Here cash flow, PVF at 8%, discounted cash flow. Can I proceed or not? Now, after how many years? 10 years. What is the cash flow? 50 lakhs. After 10 years, the cash flow required is 50 lakhs. Now, I have to find out present value factor for what percent? 8%. How many years? 10 years. Now, tell me what to do, how to calculate 8%, 10 years. Tell me. 1 divided by, all of you, 1 divided by, 1 divided by what? 1.08. 1 divided by 1.08. Press is equal to how many times? 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What the number? 0.4631. You are getting the number or not? 0.4631. Okay. Now, write the present value factor so much? 0.4631. 0.4631. Now, tell me 50 lakhs into 0.4631. Do manipulate as it is, you will be having some inaccuracy. 50,000,000 into what? 0.4631. What is the money going to get? 23,15,500. 23,15,500. 23,15,500. How much should Ram deposit today? 23,15,500. This along with how much interest? 8% interest compounded annually becomes how much here? 50 lakhs. The only thing is he should not consume interest. Interest should be what? Redeposited or reinvested for this 50 lakhs money to be available. Everybody understanding or not? Now, Purunjaba? Now, other way to get this 0.4631 is to see what table? Present value table. Let us confirm that also. See the table A3. Please see the table A3. What person, how many years? Sollupa thunga adhaya. What person, how many years? 8%, 10 years. Okay, now look at the 10 years against what person? 8%. What's the number? Point? 0.463. We had as what? 0.4631. 4 decimal only difference. Everybody understanding or not? No. With this exercise 1 is over. Right or not? Right on. Next. Exercise 2. Don't talk. Exercise 2. Shh. What would be the present value? What would be the present value for the above problem? Exercise 2. What would be the present value for the above problem? What would be the present value for the above problem? If the interest rate is, what would be the present value for the above problem? If the interest rate is 8.5%, what would be the present value for the above problem? If the interest rate is 8.5%, everything is same, 8% make it as what? 8.5%. Write down solution. Write the solution. Okay, now let's do it together. All of you, involve here. First column is what? Here. Second column is cash flow. Third column is present value factor at what percent? 8.5%. Last column is discounted cash flow. Okay, tell me which year? 10th year. Tell me the cash flow? 50 lakhs. 10th year, 50 lakhs. Now, how to find out present value factor for 8.5%? we cannot find this in table. Yes or no? That is why I said calculator is much more easier and important. Table gives you only 8 and 9. Will not give for what? 8.5. Okay, now how to calculate for 8.5% percentage factor? 1 divided by. Everybody participate. 1 divided by what? 1.085. 1 divided by 1.085. 8.5% plus is equal to how many times here? 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What's the number? 0.4423. You can have it as what? 0.4423. My number right or not? No. So it is 0.4423. 0.4423. We should multiply 50 lakhs, 50,000,000 into what? 0.4423. What's the number I want to get? 22,11,500. 22,11,500. Tell me, this number is more than this or less than this or less than this? I deposit even lesser amount because I get 0.5% extra interest. Everybody is all known. In other words, when the time value of money increases, when the time value of money increases, the present value of the money decreases. It's all known now. If the interest rate is higher, the value of the money today is what? Much more lower is the understanding. Please, understood or not? Now, with this we completed the discussion of present value of a single cash flow. Those who understood thoroughly every discussion, raise your hand. Can I proceed to the next stage or not? Now, let's go to the example 2. We want to discuss about annuity cash flow. Okay. Copy this example. Sharp nigriya pa manage panna mudiyadilla. Finished, huh? Can we start up now? No need to write anything, just participate. I'll give you time to copy at the appropriate stage. Okay. See, I receive 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh at the end of first year, at the end of second year, at the end of third year. The question is, what is the value of all these cash flows today? What is the value of all these cash flow today? Can I say that receiving 3 lakhs today is as good as receiving 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh? No, because it cannot be added. Why can't I add 1 lakh, 1 lakh and 1 lakh? They are in different time frames. They cannot be added and subtracted. Bring everything to today's terms. The common calculation. Everybody following or not? No. Why you call this as annuity? Because it same amount received n number of times. We call it as annuity. Can I proceed further? No. Let me do this in different ways and then come to a conclusion. Can I start or not? No. Participate. Here, cash flow, present value factor at how much percent? 10% discounted cash flow. Can you start or not? Tell me, year 1, year 2, year 3. What the cash flow you get? 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh. Okay. Now tell me, there are 3 single cash flows. Correct? There are what? 3 single cash flows. What you can do simply is, 1 lakh received after 1 year. What is the value today? Yes, sir. 1 lakh received after 2 years. What is the value today? Yes, sir. No, yes, sir. 1 lakh received after 3 years. What is the value today? Yes, I can find out or not? Now, that is, you discount the first cash flow by 1 year present value factor. Yes, second year cash flow by what? 2 years present value factor. Third year cash flow by what? 3 years present value factor. Are you all following what I am saying? No. So now let us calculate present value factor for first year, second year and third year. Please take the calculator. All of you take the calculator. Tell me what the interest rate? 10%. Please, you all should do and tell me. Okay. First year PVF, 1 divided by 1.10 is equal to, don't do anything, 1 by 1.10 is equal to, what's the number? 0.9091. Very simple. Another is equal to, what's the number? 0.8264. Another is equal to, what's the number? 0.7513. Everybody, yes or no? Now, I want an explanation. What is this 0.9091? 1 rupee after 1 year is 90 paise today. What is 0.8264? 1 rupee after 2 years is 82 paise today. Yes or no? Now, what is 0.7513? 1 rupee after 3 years is 75 paise today. Everybody understanding or not? Now, so what is the present value of 1 lakh rupees each? 1 lakh into 0.9091 gives you 90,910. 1 lakh into 0.8264 gives you 82,640. 1 lakh into 0.7513 gives you 75,130. Am I right or not? Now, my question is, can I add 1 lakh plus 1 lakh and 1 lakh and write 3 lakhs here? Why can't I add all this on in different time periods? This is first year, this is second, this is what? Third year. Now, my question is, can I add 90, 9, 10, 82, 640, 75, 130? Yes, why we can add? Because everything is in year zero terms. Yes or no? Everything has brought to what? Year zero. Because this 90, 9, 10 is 1 lakh in year zero value. This was 80 to 640 is what? 1 lakh in year zero value and so on. So the last column can be added or not? Tell me what the last column total? 2,48,680. In other words, receiving 1 lakh for how many years? 3 years is not equal to receiving 3 lakhs today. It is just equal to receiving what? 2,48,680 today. Everybody, are you understanding or not? Now, so tell me, what is the value of 1 lakh for 3 years in today's terms? 2,48,680 and not 3 lakhs. Everybody, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, I'll just make you understand in another way. See, I deposit 2,48,680 today. Listen, I deposit what? 2,48,680 today at 10% for 3 years. That is the maturity value. Yes, sir. I deposit 2,48,640 today at how much percent? 10% for how many years? 3 years. That's a maturity value. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
You keep that maturity value in mind. You keep the maturity value in mind. Okay, next. I deposit this 1 lakh for how many years? 2 years. I deposit the next 1 lakh for what? 1 year. And the last 1 lakh is 1 lakh. Cannot be deposited for any more time. And these three will be having a maturity value or not? Add it. Both will be what? Same. Everybody follow what I am saying? That is, what 2,48,680 can mature in 3 years, the same maturity, 1 lakh also will be giving in what? 3 years. Understanding of what I am saying. So this is what I tried to mean. If you want, I'll just explain this to the number. Okay, now tell me, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, I just receive, na? Every time I receive, I run to the bank and what? Deposit how much percent? 10%. Now, see, I am doing now compounding. I take to the future and want to do what? Compounding. Okay. Here, cash flow, I call as future value factor. I just want compound and then compound that cash flow. Now, all of you listen here. First year, second year, third year. How much I receive? 1 lakh. How much I receive? 1 lakh. How much I receive? 1 lakh. All of you, don't talk. I receive 1 lakh at the end of first year or not?
Yes,
I run to the bank, I deposit for how many years? 2 years. In a end of second year, end of third year. I want to bring it to a third year. Yes or no? I deposit how many years here? 2 years. End of first year, end of second year, end of third year. What the compound factor? 1 plus r power n. Yes or no? 1.10 power 2. In a current now. Another 1 lakh I receive after what? 2 years. What I'll do? Run to the bank and deposit how many years? 1 year. In a 2 to 3 years only, how many years here? 1 year. Yes or no? 1.10 power 1. Third 1 lakh I receive on the last day. When I receive on last day, I deposit how many years here? 0 years. So I just write 1 by 1.10 power 0. Anything raised to 0 is what? 1. Okay, now tell me. 1 lakh into 1.10 power 2. Multiply by 1.10 into 1.10 into 1 lakh. What's the number? 1 lakh? 31,000? 1 lakh? Exact term? 1,21,000. Next is what? 1,10,000. Third is what? 1 lakh. Now, can I add the three numbers or not? Yes, all are maturity value. I get a maturity value. How much rupees I am? 3,31,000. Everybody, yes or no? Now, 1 lakh for 3 years can mature to 3 lakh at the end of the 3rd year. Yes or no? Now, another issue is, today I received 2,48,680. How much I receive here? 2,48,680. We all know that future value is equal to what? Present value into 1 plus r power n. Yes or no? How much I deposit today? 2,48,680. I deposit how much percent? 10%. How many years? 3 years. Yes or no? Now, can tell me what's the number here? 2,48,680 into 1.10 power 3. What's the number? 3,31,000. 3,31,000 is the value. In the parita. Yes or no? Now, in other words, getting today 2,48,680 or getting 1 lakh for how much? 3 years. Both is going to give me the same money at the end of the 3rd year. Everybody, yes or no? Now, that is why I said the present value of 1 lakh annuity is how much rupees? 2,48,680 is the meaning of my discussion. Are you understanding it? About those who understood, raise your hand. How about then, why you can't say yes, no? Can you proceed now? I have heard it. Can you proceed? Okay, let's come back to the discussion. Now, you forget the meaning of it. Come back here. Okay, now, 1 lakh received for 3 years. Is it going to how much rupees? 2,48,680. This is the discounted cash flow for the annuity. Respond, yes or no? Now, next. I will make this computation much more simpler now. Okay, now, how I got 2,48,680? 1 lakh into 0.9091 plus 1 lakh into 0.8264 plus 1 lakh into 0.7513. Yes or no?
Yes,
in all the three calculations, 1 lakh is common. 1 lakh is what? Common. Can I take 1 lakh outside or not? No. To write it simply, it is 1 lakh into 0.9091 plus 1 lakh into 0.8264 plus 1 lakh into 0.7513. Can I take 1 lakh outside or not? It becomes 1 lakh into 0.9091 plus 0.8264 plus 0.7513. Yes or no? Now, tell me what is 0.9091 plus 8264 plus 0.7513? What's the number? 2.4868. It is 1 lakh into 2.4868. That gives you 2,48,680. Everybody, are you all following what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
Now, what happens is, this 2,48,680 is future value, present value. I am the future present value. Present value. I call it discounted cash flow. I call it what? Discounted cash flow. The cash flows have been discounted to 2,48,680. Yes or no? No. This discounted cash flow. This 1 lakh is cash flow. The 1 lakh is what? Cash flow. This 2.4868 I call as annuity factor. I call as one factor? Annuity factor. So 1 lakh is cash flow and 2.4868 is what? Annuity factor. When I multiply the cash flow by annuity factor, I get the discounted cash flow. Yes or no? So for annuity, it is annuity cash flow into what factor? Annuity factor is going to give you what cash flow? Discounted cash flow. Everybody understanding it or not?
Yes.
So now in the exam, how to present the solution? How to present the solution? I'll write it here and then proceed further. Okay, see. You are going to have 4 columns. How many columns here? 4 columns. Tell me the columns.
Yeah.
Cash flow. Annuity factor. Instead of present value factor, use what factor? Annuity factor. At what percent? 10%. Last column is discounted cash flow. Idam answer. Year cash flow, annuity factor, and what? Discounted cash flow. Year, how I write? 1, 2, 3. I receive what? 1, 2, 3. What the cash flow I receive? 1 lakh. This is the annuity cash flow. What the annuity factor? 2.4868. What annuity factor? 2.4868. What discounted cash flow? 248,680 is the answer. Everybody, yes or no? Now, 1 lakh for 3 years is as good as what? 248,680 today is a discounted cash flow for an annuity. I have told you how to calculate a DCF for an annuity. Up to this, are you following or not? Now the question is, sir, 1 to 3 where it is in the question? Enna correct? 1 lakh where it is in the question. 2.4860 we have to calculate. We have to calculate what? Annuity factor. How in single cash flow we calculate present value factor? For annuity we calculate what? Annuity factor. Everybody, yes or no? Now tell me, just for revision, present value factor now, how many ways?
Three ways.
Name the 3 ways. Formula, table, calculator. Like that, annuity factor also can be calculated in 4 ways. So calculate how many ways? Yeah, 4 ways. Let us see how to calculate the annuity factor. No need to write everything. I'll give the elaborate notes at the end of the sum. Okay, now here we are going to calculate what factor? Annuity factor. Sometimes even books write as PVAF. PVAF means what? Present value, annuity factor. Tell me, can be calculated in how many ways?
4 ways.
As usual, the first is formula. The first method is what? Formula. Second is sigma PVF. Second is what? Sigma present value factor. The third is table. And the fourth is what? Calculator. Everybody, right or not? Now let us do one by one. All of you participate. What is the formula for present value factor? 1 by 1 plus r power n. In the parade not? Like that. Annuity is having a formula. It is 1 by r into 1 minus 1 by 1 plus r power n. This is a formula for calculating what factor? Annuity factor. What's the formula? 1 by r into 1 minus 1 by 1 plus r power n. Yes or no? Now, please substitute the number for me. What is 1 by r? 1 by r is 10% means what? 0.10. 1 by 0.10 into 1 minus 1 by 1.10 power 3. Ennappa right or not? 1 by 0.10 into 1 minus 1 by 1.10 power 3. Enna right? Now we have to calculate. Now 1 by 1.10 power 3 is 0.7513. Enna correct? Yes or no? Now look at this. 1 minus 0.7513. 1 minus 1 by r, 1 minus 0.7513. Enna pa right or not? Now, it is going to give you how much? A 0.2487. Divided by what? 0.10. What am I going to get? 2.487. We had what? 2.4868. It has been rounded off to what? 2.487. So, we can have it as what? 2.4868. I'll call it. Okay. Accurate calculator gives you 2.4868. This is a present value of what? 1 rupee annuity factor. Everybody, yes or no? Now, tell me what the formula for calculating annuity factor? 1 by r into 1 minus 1 by 1 plus r power n. So it is 1 by 0.1 into 1 minus 1 by 1.10 power 3. You got in the calculator as 2.487. We had in our, say, yearly calculation 2.4860. Both are correct. Everybody, yes or no? Now, next is, what is annuity factor? Very simple. Tell me here, how I got 2.4868? Somebody tell me, how I got 2.4868? I total the present value factors. I total what? Present value factor. Sigma present value factor is what? Annuity factor. Ennappa right or not? Now, yes or no? Now, tell me, what is the present value factor for first year? 9091. Second year? 0.8264. Third year? 0.7513. When I total the annuity factor? 2.4868 is yet another way of calculating the annuity factor. Everybody, right or not? Now, third way is to see what? Table. See present value annuity table. See what? Present value annuity table. Take the workbook, please. Take the workbook. A4 table you see. Please see A4 table. Against how much percent? How many years? 10%, 3 years. See, against 10%, 3 years. Okay, what is 3 years? What is 10%? 2.487. You have what? 2.487. So, you are getting the number as 2.487. Is the annuity factor calculated using what? The annuity table. Everybody write or not? நம்ம எல்லாம் இருக்கியாப்பா? Are you all following up? Now, the last is doing what using calculator. Very simple. See. You want to find out annuity factor at what person? 10%. How much person? 10%. How many years? 3 years. Very simple. Take the calculator. 1 divided by 1.10. 1 divided by what? 1.10. How many years? 3 years. First year, second year, third year. Press grand total, I get what? 2.4868. Plus you get what? 2.4868. Annuity factor of how many years? 3 years. Nothing great. 1 divided by 1.10. When I press first year, I get first year present value factor. Yes or no? Calculator keeps it in its memory. Yes or no? Another is equal to get what? 0.8264. It keeps in what? Memory. Third is what? 0.7513 keeps in what? Memory. So annuity factor is total present value factor, right or not? So here plus grand total, all equal to numbers will be what? Total. So I'll be getting how much? 2.4868. Already clapped. 2.4868 is the annuity factor. Enough for right or not? I am going to give a police complaint in Ungambaka police station. Okay, now. Faculties are ragged. Okay. Security issue. Can I proceed? Shall I proceed? No. So, how to calculate a calculator? First, we have to type what? 1 by 1.10. Type 1 by 1.10. Please tell me next is what? Press what? Is equal to how many times? 3 times. Third is what? Press a grand total. Will be getting the annuity factor. Everybody, yes or no? Now, please. Shh. This is how we should calculate present value of an annuity cash flow. Everybody understand or not? Now, please. Shh. Okay. Okay, this is the answer here. Let us consolidate, please. What was the question? 1 lakh received for 3 years. What is the value today if the interest rate is 10%? Are you with me or not? Now, they ask you to calculate the present value of 3 years, 1 lakh. Singular annuity. Annuity. How to calculate? Tell me the solution columns. Year, cash flow, annuity factor at 10%, discounted cash flow. Single cash flow na present value factor, annuity cash flow means what? Annuity factor. That's the only change. Yes or no? Now, year is 1 to 3, cash flow is what? 1 lakh. How to calculate? Annuity factor. Tell me how to calculate annuity factor? 4 ways. Tell me what are the 4 ways of calculating annuity factor? Formula, sigma PDF, table, calculator. What is the formula for calculating annuity factor, everybody? 1 by r into 1 minus 1 by 1 plus r power n. What is the next item? Total the present value factors. Which table are you going to see? Annuity table, A4 table you have to see. And calculate the type 1 divided by 1.10 is equal to 3 times. And press what? Grand total. Simply calculate present value factor and press the grand total. That's all. Everybody is on know. That is how one should find out the annuity factor. Enna pa purinjada? Now, last issue and then I'll just give you the notes. Sir, what is this 2.4868? Question arises now. What is the meaning of what? Annuity factor 2.4868. Simple. 1 rupee received for what? 3 years is not 3 rupees. It's only what? 2 rupees 48 paise. Respond is or no? 111 rupee received for 3 years is not 3 rupees. It's only what? 2 rupees 48 paise. So 1 lakh received for 3 years is not 3 lakh. It's only what? 2,48,680 is the meaning of it. Everybody understood or not? With this, we completed the discussion regarding present value of annuity cash flow. Yes or no? Can I pose it? Write down. Next, example 2. Have you finished copying example 2? Yes, sir. Example copied.
Yes, sir.
This has been copied or not?
Yes, sir.
Can I pose it? Write down. Solution. Write down solution. One by one. Copy the slide quickly. Stop talking, please. Write down. Alternative 2. There's alternative 2. Nothing but 1 lakh is taken outside and the factors are added. We can write present value annuity factor, or even we can simply call as what? Annuity factor. Both are understandable.